Good evening, all. Let's pray. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up by narrow domestic walls, where words come from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habits, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. We shall now all sing song number 3, Lappe Aati Hai Dua. Thank you, choir and orchestra. May I request everyone to be seated, please. Ladies and gentlemen, to the prize giving and farewell assembly for the class of 2023. Before I call upon my school captain to deliver his address, I take it to be my honest duty to welcome amongst us our chief guest for this evening, Dr. Professor John Varghese, Principal St. Stephen's College, New Delhi. A little I say about him, the more I run short of words, because a man of that repute, with that caliber, and with the potential what he carries with him, is hard to describe. Professor John Varghese is heading St. Stephen's College since 2016. He has been the head Department of Communication in EFL University, has taught English language and literature at George Mason University, UAE, and Stephen's College, Delhi, to undergrad students, has taught English language to undergrad students at Loyola Evening College, Chennai, in India. He has also taught government officials in Cambodia on behalf of the Government of India an English language proficiency course. Research and research supervision. Professor Varghese has supervised two MPhil research projects in the areas of British and the century British fiction. He has joint supervisor for two PhDs, research project on British and American fiction, respectively. Professor also serves on the governing body and the EC of the two state universities and a central university. He has also held various responsibilities at EFL University as Deputy Dean International Relations, Dean in Charge International Relations, Dean School of Communication, and Placement Officer. In corporate training, ladies and gentlemen, Professor has conducted several training programs in communication skills, English language for government agencies in India, including Parasat Bharati and National Institute of Tourism and Hospitality Management at Hyderabad. As principal, his responsibilities involved are comprehensive and cover all aspects of the college with regards to academics, administration, and financial. He represents the college at university at ministry level meetings. The position also entails discussions with agencies at national and international levels with partnering institutions. I'm extremely honored, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to welcome Professor John Varghese this evening, and I'm sure he will enjoy this time with us. Welcome to the Doon School, Professor. May I now request our school captain of 23-24, Tarun Matthew Doss, J310, to come and address the cabinet.
In most amusement parks around the world, roller coaster rides don't last more than a few minutes. Yet, as your stomach lurches and your hair rises, you try to maintain a stoic face, twisting and turning over under and around. In all that excitement, as your adrenaline ebbs and flows, you think you've been there for hours on end, and when the ride finishes, you understand why the next set of people must get on. But you long for it to happen all over again. Doon is a lot like that. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Professor John Varghese, Headmaster, esteemed teachers, dear parents, my fellow DOSCOs, and last but certainly not least, the outstanding batch of 2023. 5 years ago, I stumbled almost by chance into school, and as I have said before, everything was disproportionately out of size back then. The gates, the huge seniors, and the iconic oversized Harlequin sports shirts. Everything except my guide Viraj, of course. But strangely, soon enough, something began to happen. That dense smell of monsoon turned into that smell of the eagerly awaited football season. The cacophonic sound of the music school turned slowly into sweet song. And before I knew it, the sight of my seniors now turned into one that I won't see for long. This community opened its arms and pulled me in, and soon I was on the inside, watching other new kids stumble into school. And as the years go by, these large, imposing buildings slowly turn into nothing but memories small enough to fit inside my head. 5 years have all zipped by like that roller coaster, and here I am standing before you at the start of my last. But today is not about me. It's about the people who made me who I am today. It's about the best 6 years of their lives that this evening, looking back, probably feels like 6 minutes. It's about the batch of 23 seated before us for one last time together in this Rose Bowl. I would have never thought this day would come as quickly as it did. It feels like just yesterday when they were restless sea farmers, as all sea farmers are, counting down the minutes to when they could escape the seemingly never-ending speeches and go on their night outs. Time really does move differently within these walls. Sets of children come and go, trickling in with teary eyes and marching out with them too. You'd have to live it to believe it. As I look into the crowd today, I seem to be in a sort of dilemma. I don't know whether to burst into laughter or into tears. In other words, should I be sad that it's all over, or should I smile because it happened? I know I'm not the only one stuck in this dilemma today. I see through the smiling faces of all my batchmates seated before me, and into that vacuum I know that they all know they'll soon be feeling in their hearts. The vacuum that I will feel when I make my daily trip to the music school, only to notice that Nigam and Prakash's dynamic duo are nowhere to be found, but only the echoes of their bellowing voices still travel down the corridors. The vacuum I'll feel when I realize that the entirety of Tata House and I will actually be able to get our 7 hours of sleep, knowing that we won't have to hear Mundra's political TED Talks at 3 in the morning. The vacuum I'll feel when I just need someone to talk to, and by habit go to Baby Shark Dungapur study, only to find all their studies now empty. But my dear SELs, that is when I will tell myself, broken hearts are the ones that who are truly loved. Except yours, Goofy, she's never calling back. I can't say that I know how you feel, because to be honest, I can't even begin to imagine what it must be like sitting where you are today. I can't, and deep down somewhere know that I don't want to. But what I can do today is to tell you boys that all of you have certainly left your mark on this institution. It doesn't matter if your names aren't etched on one of the 100 honor boards in school today. It doesn't matter if your tie is of a different color. What makes us special is DOSCOs, is that no matter who you were or where you are from, what really matters in the end is what you have become and all that you have done in this place we call home. At the end of the day, it is your story which will be carried forward by generations of DOSCOs to come. After you spend hours decoding your scraggly deform handwritings in your letter to your future self, which you wrote in Martin and Foothouse, and were finally able to read it with that overwhelming spell of nostalgia, did you get a chance to reflect on the young adult you've grown into? Would that shy 3-for-3 boy look up to you today and think, wow, look at that guy, I want to be like him? Well, it is my promise on behalf of the entire school community that every single one of you has succeeded in your own unique way. And I think that that is what makes the exceptional batch of 23 all the more exceptional. You will all in some way or another be immortalized in some junior's heart. Your story will be a source of inspiration for many more to come, and you will leave this institution with a legacy. But then there are those of you who in your own eyes, I know, feel that you might not have lived your school life to the fullest. To you, I say that this might be the end of your time here in Doon, but as one chapter comes to a close, it turns the page for a whole new one filled only with more possibilities, more excitement, and more success. And now for my much-awaited conclusion. I would have dozed off by now if I was in your place. If I try hard enough, I can hear the kids whisper just like we did back in our C farm, "Yaar, koi se chup karao." To the batch of 23 seated before me today, look at the person on your left and on your right. It might be a long time till you see him again, but no matter where you are, know that the road will always lead you home, lead you here. We live within walls, red brick walls. We enter this campus through majestic gates and leave the chaos and the dust of the world behind. Little do we realize the true value of these walls. They not only cut out dust and chaos, they cut out the inclemency of reality. Now it is time for you, the batch of 2023, to return to that reality. So don't forget the past, instead embrace it. Remember the good times, remember the bad, and remember the ugly, and cherish every moment just the same. I wish that we'd known we were in the good old days before they got over, but that is the beauty of impermanence. It is what makes life special. In the end, all I'd like to say is best of luck, batch of 2023. Thank you for everything, and Godspeed.
Thank you so much for that lovely address, Tarun. And I was told by Ajay, my first school captain when I came, he said, if there's no humor in your speech is meaningless. Thank you for that excellent humor in your speech. Well, DOSCOs, this is what we were waiting for, our chief guest address. And it gives me immense pleasure to invite him now to call on the stage to say, Professor Varghese, the stage is yours now. We want to hear you. Thank you so much for coming all the way to the Doon School.
Respected Headmaster Dr. Singh, my colleagues in the teaching fraternity, Happy parents of the graduating batch of 2023. Members of Doon School, and especially my dear graduating boys of 2023. Good evening. It's a pleasure and an honor to be here this evening. Thank you, Headmaster, for inviting me to this very special day in the life of your institution. This is my first visit to the Doon School. I came here this morning, but the warmth and the love and the affection which I have received in the past few hours makes me feel that I have been here forever. Thank you very much for the courtesies, but more importantly, thank you very much for making me feel warm, welcome, and wanted. Today is a very special day, especially for the graduating batch and the parents of the graduating batch. I listened to Tarun speak, and he seemed to be in a quandary about whether he should laugh or whether he should burst into tears. Let me tell you that you should burst into laughter. Laughter, because that is the strength on which each one of you, I mean the graduating batch, should go forward. You may not think that you have achieved much, but you have. To complete 12 years of education and in one of the finest schools in this country is no easy task. And you have done that. And therefore, you need to carry with you that sense of achievement. But you should also remember that this, like Tarun also mentioned, this is but one phase. And so, as the principal of one of the best institutions, higher institutions, to which I hope many of you will apply and eventually come, let me tell you that there is much to be done. Your country awaits the role that you are going to play. The world awaits for what you can give the world. My message to each one of you who is graduating today is that set your sights high as you can reach, because you have it in you. I am talking on the basis of what I have seen and experienced, not only at St. Stephen's College, from where you have many masters here in this institution, but also on the basis of young men and women who have gone out from my institution into the world and changed the world. You are no less. And what you have got from this institution, from your headmaster, from the masters, from everybody who belongs to the Dosco family, it is up to you now to take it forward. And what you need to do is look back on what you have got from your school. Reflect on the challenges you have faced, on what your headmaster and masters and even non-teaching staff have given you, and then resolve to do your bit to take the world forward. You know that our country and our world, we need young men and women to take it forward. We've come a long distance, but it's not enough. We need you to be creative, to put all your learning together. We need you to fall back on what you've been taught, both in the classroom and outside. And we need you to make a difference to our world. Your headmaster, your masters, your institution has made sacrifices. Your parents have made sacrifices. They may not have told you about it, but if you look intently, you will find that they have made sacrifices. And their sacrifices must not go in vain. Their sacrifices must be recognized, and you must take their sacrifices forward so that your parents, your entire school will be happy and will smile on seeing your achievements. Mark my words, I use the plural achievements. I do not use it in the singular, because the world is out there. This is an important moment when you move from being school children into being young adults. The move is not easy, but believe me, you are prepared for it. You have it in you. Resolve to take it forward. God bless each one of you as you go forward into the world. May the decisions that you have taken be good decisions. May they bring happiness to you, success to you, happiness to your families, and glory to your institution. Congratulations once again, and thank you very much for this opportunity.
May I now request Professor to accept a small token of love and appreciation from the school, which is prepared by the Design and Technology Department of our school. Kindly accept it as with the same love and affection we have made it for you. May I request the orchestra and choir now to present their performance, please.
Touch me. back to the night we met. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, haunted by the ghost of you. Take me back to the night we met.
Thank you so much, choir and the orchestra, for this excellent performance. Let's hear it once again as a Dosco clap for these guys. Our Deputy Headmaster, Mr. K. Elliott, to please come and take the further proceedings.
And good evening, everyone. I'm going to be announcing the awards and prizes under various categories. These awards and prizes are for the academic year 2022-2023 and are pertaining to the SC form. All recipients are requested to come in from the right-hand side of the stage, and please exit from the left when I call out your name. I would like to request the headmaster to please come and award the first set of prizes. Some of these young men who I will call on stage are going to receive more than one award and will therefore be on stage a bit longer than the others. So the first category is academics. These are marker cups and headmaster's cup for SC form ISC. So the marker cup for English language goes to Gurmer Singh Bedi, 331K. For English literature, goes to Ranshir Singh Mann, 148K. Ranshir, please don't go far away. We need you once again. So I think you might need some assistance. The Headmaster's Cup for Accounts also goes to Ranshir Singh Mann, 148K. The Headmaster's Cup for Economics goes to Raghav Mundra, 2070. Raghav, you know the drill, so please stay. The Headmaster's Cup for Commerce also goes to Raghav Mundra, 2070. The Headmaster's Cup for psychology also goes to Raghav Mundra, 2070. The marker cup for mathematics goes to Siddhant Kumar Singh, 151T. The Headmaster's Cup for Chemistry goes to Siddhant Kumar Singh, 151T. The Headmaster's Cup for History goes to Adi Jain, 168H. Political Science goes to Uddhav Satya Prakash Goyal, 133K. The Headmaster's Cup for Legal Studies goes to Ahan Jaykumar, 340O. The Headmaster's Cup for Indian Music, Hindustani, goes to Aryan Prakash, 1870. Thank you very much. For the next set of awards, I will now request our chief guest, Dr. Professor John Varghese, to kindly give out the awards and prizes. Sir, if I may, thank you. It's for co-curricular awards. So for art, the Best Painter Award goes to Satvik Anand, 339J. Punalata Das Tamina Salim Ali Trophy for the Best Artist goes to Siddhant Agarwal, 129H. The award for the Best Digital Artist goes to Avi Sani, 123T. Mel Bhagat Trophy for Excellence in Theatre, English goes to Sudhanshu Chaudhary, 1940. The Sandeep Malhotra Trophy for the Best Supporting Actor in English Play goes to Aryan Chaudhary, 191T. The Super Rama Award for Contribution to Hindi Drama goes to Katyayan Kanodia, 159H. The trophy for the best actor in Hindi play goes to Aryan Gautam, 125H. The trophy for the best supporting actor in Hindi play goes to Paras Agarwal, 164J. And now for music. The Vaman Shirodkar Trophy for the Best Musician of the Year goes to Aryan Prakash, 1870. Music goes to Uday Singh Dungapur, 127J. I will be reading out a brief citation after announcing the name of the recipient. The Shantam Seth Trophy for the Most Promising Naturalist of the Year goes to Avisani, 123T. Now, with a high sense of commitment and determination, Avi has served the school community in terms of raising awareness about natural and environmental issues under the Nest Society. He inspired many juniors towards gaining their interest in nature through promotion of activities such as bird watching and owling. Please come down, Avi. The Karan Dhari Lal Memorial Trophy for the Best Metal Work in SC Form goes to G.V. Anish Reddy, 197H. Thank you. The Ramanan Trophy for the best motor mechanic of the year goes to Krishmeet Singh Ratra, 130T. And now for sports. These awards are for sporting achievements at IPSC, state or national level. I will be reading a brief citation after announcing the names of the recipients. I will request the recipients to come on stage after the citation has been shared. In some cases, I will be announcing two names. So for athletics, Amrit Agarwal, 193H. Amrit was a member of the 4 into 400 meters relay team that won the gold at the All India IPSC Athletics Meet in 2022. For basketball, Tejas Sharma, 175T, and Tejveer Singh Dhingra, 206T. Tejas and Tejveer represented Uttarakhand state and participated in the 72nd Junior National Basketball Championship in January 2023. Please come down to the stage, gentlemen. Now for swimming, Aryan Prakash, 187O, and Vinamra Agarwal, 338K. Aryan won a silver medal in the 1500 meter freestyle and a bronze medal in the 200 meter freestyle event at the 35th All India IPSC swimming competition. Vinamra won a bronze medal in the 50 meter butterfly event. Aryan and Vinamra were also members of the under 19 team that won the gold in the 4 into 100 meter freestyle relay and silver medal in the 4 into 100 meters medley relay at the IPSC swimming competition. Gentlemen, can you please? Hockey. Abhiman Pratap Singh, 332K. Abhiman was awarded the best defender of the IPSC Under 19 hockey tournament. The school team won the bronze medal in the tournament. For round square, the King Constantine Award, which is actually a medal, for contribution to round square ideal goes to Maharishi Roy, 333H. And finally, for social service, the Kavar G.B. Singh Award, which is again a medal for community service, goes to Paras Agarwal, 164J. Thank you, Dr. Varghese. Please do take a seat, sir. Thank you very much. So to all the recipients, I now invite the school captain for the year 2022-2023, Raghav Mundra, 207T, to deliver his speech.
A fortnight had passed since we came to school on the 31st of April 2017, and we were finally allowed to call our parents. As an international student, I couldn't use the house phone lines and went to STK ma'am, our housemaster, to ask for help. I'm sure our parents were equally eager to hear the voices of their innocent young boys. Ma'am lent me her phone, and as the phone rang, my pulse kept increasing, but somehow I managed to keep myself together. When my dad picked up, even before greeting him, my first message to him was, and I quote, "Whoever sits for Doon's entrance exam is doomed. If you don't get selected, you taste rejection at a relatively early stage of your life. And if you do get selected, well, then you end up behind the bars of this jail." And I whispered this into the phone very faintly, ensuring that STK ma'am, who was sitting in the room beside, doesn't hear any of it. Little did I know that this same place would end up becoming the best thing to happen to me and to countless others. Scrambling to write this speech over the past few days, I am filled with bittersweet emotions between the nostalgia of my first interaction with the batch of 23 in the AMC and the disappointment of what is soon going to be my last. On one hand, I am grateful to have the opportunity of condensing my whole journey down to this one last speech. On the other hand, I am filled with a deep sense of nostalgia as we bid farewell to this place we have called home for the last 6 years. Each day spent here has taught me something new, and I accredit a huge part of who I am to Doon. I think my batch will agree with me when I say that a lot has changed since we joined school, for better or for worse. And as a batch, we have come to grips with the fact that we need to change with changing times. This acceptance of reality constitutes a huge part of this change. As responsible members and well-wishers of the community, I've often been asked this question as the school captain again and again, whether the school has followed a downward spiral post-pandemic. After giving it a deep thought, I believe that it is a wrong question to ask because it is an unfair comparison. While the pandemic forced people to lose touch with each other, organizations all over the world have had to recalibrate in a bid to adjust to new ways of work and life at large. This doesn't mean that we leave our traditions and culture behind, but from my perspective, the right metric to judge our progress would be to see if we have flourished as a school as a whole from where we started last year. And I see a clear answer. As the first batch post-pandemic to have experienced our whole SC form without disruptions, I am eternally grateful and proud that we were able to establish a sense of belonging and build a foundation for school to thrive exponentially with learnings from the past to ensure a better future. I like to believe that Doon doesn't take up 6 years of our lifetime. Rather, it gives us a lifetime of 6 years. Some like to believe that Doon follows the notion of survival of the fittest. But over the last few years, especially in our SC form, I've witnessed that Chandbagh has a right place for everyone and has everyone in their right place. As a batch, we have come a long way, and today we may have to go out of Doon, but Doon will never go out of us. While Doon is certainly unique, I've also had the privilege of studying in an exceptionally unique batch. The class of 2023 was characterized by a gracious alliance with a renowned school in the city. But despite the sheer dedication and extraordinary efforts of various individuals, Vellum Girls was destined to be our sister school. A few warriors' love for each other transcended lamination paper to say the least, as we saw perfect cutouts of an unevolved prefect from the main building notice board to a certain Tada House study, purely for college motivation though. Regarding college and career, directions from Bindalpur to Mall Road and then a sharp left turn to Young Road without stopping anywhere in between was memorized by the ISC boys better than calculus formulas a night before the math board exam. a minimum requirement of 60 in each subject, including math, did not stop our lead vocalist and choir leader from passing on the legacy of his predecessor by legally rolling the best Carties, of course. While Hyderabad House may not have outperformed everyone in sports and extracurriculars, their academics and scholarly activities definitely witnessed an all-time high. Talking about highs, the birthday of two swans saw a throw-up battle as certain sly individuals pushed themselves beyond their limits while the manager struggled to keep granny's sofas and carpets in shape. I have always wished that when the day for us to leave finally arrives, I could look across the audience and see DOSCOs who have been transformed, uplifted, and inspired by the things my batch has done. Jokes aside, I can vouch for the impact that each one of you has had in different capacities and different fields, just through your presence and constant guidance. Our biggest achievement as a batch was that we were able to leave a mark on this community. From D form to SC form, every inquisitive writer, every excellent debater, every exceptional sportsperson, and every influential leader can bear testimony to that. This speech would be incomplete without sending across a few messages. To my juniors, as time passes, you will realize the value of intangibles in school. More than the number of awards, the color of your ties, or other recognitions in school, your perception is defined by your willingness to work hard, your ability to carry everyone together, and your caliber to bring something new to the table. As a junior, I never understood why tears ran down each and every SEL's cheeks to the tune of Auld Lang Syne. As I try to hold back those same tears today, I have only one message for you. There are some things that can only be understood if you have experienced it yourself, if you have lived it through. Doon pushes you out of your comfort zone all the time to make you guys the best version of yourself. There will always be some decisions that you like and some that you don't. But my only request is for you to place your faith in the long-standing legacy and well-built systems of this place. To all the masters, till date, it amazes me how you manage to strike the right balance between compassion and austerity every single time. We often say that a Doon school boy is different from any other public school boy, but this applies to Doon school masters as well. On drawing parallels between both students' and masters' lives, we can undoubtedly conclude that they have high levels of congruency. From ordering food for students to catching students catch ordered food. From narrating personal chronicles in classes to contesting in various tournaments on the field. From recounting timeless truths to sometimes even covering our tracks. We cannot thank you enough for your paramount presence in each of our lives. And finally, to the batch of 23. A master recently asked a few of us whether we wanted to go back and relive this journey of 6 years. Without a single moment of thought, all of us unanimously agreed that we would opt to retrace our steps back in time without undoing any chapter, whether it was good, bad, or ugly. Not once, not twice, but as many times as it was offered to us. The fear of this assembly getting over too soon, just like the past 6 years, is evident on each and everyone's face right now. Right now, I just wish we could sit in the gazebo outside the CDH one last time as proud Martin House boys. I just wish we could run one last extra PT administered by NTC Sir for reporting late to the main field. I just wish we could play one last match of futsal till 6:59 p.m., panicking to make it to dinner at 7. I just wish we could sing Lappe Aati Hai in the Rose Bowl one last time as proud DOSCOs. I can't thank each one of you enough for transforming Chandbagh from being a final destination to a marvelous journey. A journey of unparalleled thrill, intricate conflicts, never-ending anecdotes, and unbreakable bonds. As I look at some of you in this outfit for the last time, I cannot help but recount a million memories that we've made together. Right from crying in each other's arms as timid deformers, knowing we have one whole week left before we go back home. to crying in each other's arms tonight as bold SELs, knowing that we have only 1 week left to go back home. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Raghav. I know how you're feeling. And don't say this was your last address from Rose Bowl. Even General Ravin Khosla said that we got him back as a chief guest to our founders. There's never the last word from the school captain. Three great speeches, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. And now they put headmaster to put up his message. Let me put across some serious words without much of a humor. Good evening to our chief guest this evening, Dr. Professor John Varghese, Principal St. Stephen's College. To my class of 2023, proud parents, ladies and gentlemen, masters, girls and boys, there comes a time in the life of every young person when a decision has to be made. One path chosen out of many. One direction selected in the compass of your life. You, my dear students, have reached this exciting juncture today. You are standing at the threshold of infinite possibilities, a lifetime of achievements, and the potential of greatness. You have many choices. You have many choices to make about higher studies, institutions and universities you want to study in, a career that will bring you deep, lifelong satisfaction. I also hope that you are making the correct choices to become an upright and responsible citizen of our country and the world. I and your teachers hope that out of everything else we have taught you, you have absorbed three lessons completely. The first is your duty to improve the state of the world by being aware of the inequity, injustice, and insensitivity that are still around us. And from awareness, you move to action so that you are motivated to protect the needy, lift up the marginalized, and bring a healing touch to those who are in pain. I know the word social reform sounds idealistic and perhaps daunting, but you can bring in individual reform by helping one person in need, then a few more and a few more. You don't have to ignore your own dreams and aspirations. No, not at all. But you can still find the internal and external resources to be compassionate and generous. You will find great satisfaction and contentment, my dear boys and girls, when you do so. The second lesson that I hope you will carry back with you is your role to protecting this planet. We know that climate change is a terrifying reality that is already wreaking havoc in the country, in the world, in the globe. But all is not lost yet, my dear boys and girls. And you, in your personal and professional capacity, can make a significant contribution towards healing the damage. In school, you have learned how you can take small daily steps that our planet needs from you. Ban the use of single-use plastic, save electricity and petrol, don't waste water, plant trees, don't buy products needlessly, start composting your garbage, and above all, reduce, reuse and recycle has been told to you again and again in the many societies of our school. I'm hoping that some of you might even go forward and work in the fields of ecology and environmental science, or set up industries with incredible new technologies that solve age-old problems of pollution and wastage. With science on your side, my dear class of 23, you can do it. The third lesson to my class of 23 is that I hope you will never forget is that of social and emotional inclusion. We are human beings first, and our first and strongest loyalty must be to the values of humanity. Judge a person on the basis of her or his capabilities, value systems, beliefs, attitudes, their personality traits, and never on the basis of race, religion, caste, region, gender, disability, sexual orientation, or age. Just leave these factors out of the equation. Because when you include them, girls and boys, you generalize. You believe that everyone belonging to a particular group or community is the same. That is dangerous generalization. Unworthy of bright young minds like yours, go forth and practice the values of acceptance, inclusion, and open-mindedness. Teach this value to others too. Now that you have completed your 6 years journey at school, I hope you will look back on them with love, loyalty, and gratitude. You grew up with us, matured and evolved into commendable young men and women. The houses, the classrooms, the corridors rang with your joyful voices and laughter. You leave your imprint on the school. And who can forget your mischief, your pranks, your mad ideas? They enrich the environment of this school too. Your achievements, whether in academics, sports, or co-curricular activities, will remain engraved in the annals of the school. And I know what the school taught you will remain engraved on your minds and hearts. Very importantly, Doscos, you have built the strongest bonds of friendships with your schoolmates, with your classmates. These are friends who will stay friends for life. These are friends who know you inside out and still enjoy the show. Hang on to them. You were fortunate enough to be a member of a community that has produced leaders and winners for nearly 88 years now. Please remember our school's legacy and heritage wherever you go. Uphold them, celebrate them. Remember the human values you were imbibed with. Stay faithful to them. You will, I know, wear the Dosco badge with pride and in return, make us proud of you. Yes, you will miss school. You will miss school. You will get nostalgic about your time here. I know for a fact that years, even decades from now, when you hear the first stirring strains of Lappe Aati Hai Dua, there will be a lump in your throat. Boys and girls, your destiny is in your hands. Shape it well. The school has prepared you to take this challenge on. Enjoy the journey ahead. The world is your oyster. So go on and cultivate 1,000 pearls. I bid you a fond farewell. God bless you. Have a wonderful journey ahead. May I now request, the boys have prepared a beautiful video. We'll have to orient our chairs here, the chief guest, Professor, and we'll play the video on the screen. Thank you.
और ये अभी गर्मी के दिन में एसटी फॉर्म में मैंने
यारी तेरी यारी चलवाना इस बारी सारी मेरी फिक्रें तेरे आगे आखिरी हारी यारी तेरी यारी चल माना इस बारी सारी मेरी फिक्र तेरे आगे आखिरी हारी खूब लगी मुझको तेरी बीमारी इस बेढंगी दुनिया के संगी हम न होते यारा अपनी तो यारी अतरंगी है कल में रंगी शाम हूं तंगी बस मलंगी यारा अपनी तो यारी अतरंगी है रे अतरंगी रे
राजदार yaaro mohabbat hi to bandagi hai ye na ho to kya phir bolo ye zindagi hai koi to dilbar ho yaar jisko tujhse ho pyar koi to dilbar ho yaar तो साया बने तेरा वो दोस्त नाचे भी वो तेरी खुशी में अरे यारो दोस्ती बड़ी ही हसीन है ये ना हो तो क्या फिर बोलो ये जिंदगी है कोई तो हो राजदार बेगरज तेरा हो यार कोई तो हो राजदार जिसकी वफा तेरे लिए हो अरे यारो मोहब्बत
थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर दिस एक्सीलेंट वीडियो एंड इट मस्ट बी वेरी नॉस्टैल्जिक फॉर द क्लास ऑफ 23 आई एम श्योर द इवनिंग इज नॉट ओवर येट पिक्चर तो अभी बाकी है मेरे दोस्त Now we have some very important awards. And I'm sure the gentleman here must be waiting for the suspense to now be revealed. And this is an honor for me. First of all, to present trophy for the Gentleman Player of the Year 2022. No suspense there. Kapil Thapli, 214K. May I request Dr. Professor Varghese to join me in giving this award? General Proficiency Cup, Marker Cup for General Proficiency Senior goes to Gurmehar Singh Bedi, 331K. And now, the most awaited school colors. This boy has been the role model for younger students, excelled in academics, excellent debater, impactful leadership as a house captain. With no further suspense here, it is Gurmeer Singh Bedi, 331K. Coming next, the gentleman I'm going to talk about is a true inspiration for the juniors. His contribution has been immense as a school prefect. His all-round achievements, be it in academics, sports, or co-curricular activities. It gives me a lot of pride to announce this name, Kapil Thapli, 214K for School Colors. Congratulations, Kapil. And the next boy is no surprise. His contribution as the school boxing captain, high standards of academic dedication, and strong leadership as a school captain. Raghav Mundra, 207T, as a school colors. Congratulations, Raghav. And the next boy who's made a huge impact, a very high achiever in academics, a very talented swimmer. You've already guessed it. An outstanding and dedicated musician, school music captain, Aryan Prakash, 1870. Congratulations, Aryan, for the school colors. The next boy, I always used to tell him wherever I used to meet him, he's an idol school, public school boy. I know you've guessed it right. Motivated the juniors in athletics and music. Impacted the school community with his hard work and dedication. An outstanding musician, contribution in founders and various music productions, contribution as a school prefect. In fact, one of the most wonderful boy we've seen, always so well conducted, always so correct. Veer Nigam, 203J. That gave you an opportunity for that. Okay. I could still see in the dark something happening. The next, girls and boys, ladies and gentlemen, is the mentor and the role model for the juniors. Boy in charge for the Infinity Society, prominent member of Mathematics Society and the Senior English Debating Society, and his contribution as the school council secretary, my blue-eyed boy, Yuvraj Shada, 204J. Last but not the least, He always conducted himself with grace and humility. Editor-in-chief of Himayat's School Social Service Magazine, contribution in MUN conferences and various rounds for international service projects, exemplary contribution as a school prefect and a school social service secretary. No suspense. Paras Agarwal, 164J. All the school color awardees to be in the foyer of the main building at 7 p.m. for a photograph for the yearbook. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I will now request our orchestra and choir now to move to the place, please. This is the most emotional moment now. When the school choir would be singing the most beautiful number, which is symbolic to this evening. And one last time, the class of 23 boys will be coming for the last shake hand with the headmaster and deliver hugs as goodbyes. This will be the last time, in formal way, they would be saying goodbye to the school. I know what is going on in their hearts. Wish they could never step into this circle again, but they want to for the one last time. May I now request the class of 23 to walk from here, come on the center, receive the lamp, and let's have one last hug. May I request the choir and the orchestra to sing the song for us.
Thank you. Take the path of Thank you.